Hi, I'm Vinitha.
I'm Jose.
We are the duo behind Jose's Travel Tales. The reason why I started this particular blog was, one is so that I document my travels, so that after a lot of years, when I grow old, I can sit back and read and also relive those good times. Another reason is because I wanted to share and inspire other people so that they also explore and get to see the beautiful world we have. I started traveling at a very young age, I think from when I was like 2 or 3. My parents love to travel, especially my dad, so I think he passed on his traveling genes to me. And since then, every time we get an opportunity, we've always set out and we've explored places. In the beginning, it was only within India, and then once I grew a little older, we started doing more international trips. For me, travel is not a way to escape life. Instead, it's a time for me to relax, unwind, and learn something new. Because every time we travel, I end up learning something new which I didn't know before. So travel is the greatest teacher.
My travel experience started in Bangalore. That's the location where I used to work. So I used to find many of my friends through a community, and we used to step out every weekend, go outside of the city and explore the nature. You know, that closeness with nature is something which inspired me to travel more and more.
One of the reasons why a lot of couples don't travel is because they always consider travel to be expensive, and they think that if they travel, they're going to make a big hole in their pockets, which is not true. We have a few tips for you so that you can do some smart travel. So one of the top tips that we have to give you is always go for a free walking tour. Most of the cities, at least in Europe, if you go to, they have a free walking tour which will be organized either by some local tourist company or in association with the government. So we try to go for that. And once we finish the tour, we usually pay a small donation to our tourist guide. We always suggest going for this because it's the best way to explore every city, because you get to walk. You also learn a lot about the culture, the people. We get a lot of food recommendations. We also get a lot of free maps and small things like that, so which really help. So free walking tour is a must.
We highly recommend you guys to take Airbnb. We have had amazing experiences. You know, you get the home-like feeling, then you can make your own food, which actually cuts down, which makes it more economical our trip, because we don't have to eat out always. And then you get that real local experiences, because you're sharing, sometimes you're sharing the rooms with a local person, and he gets to tell you the what you should do and what you should not do when you're in a specific touristic spot.
Usually if we are in a particular city just for like say 1 or 2 days, and we're going to be spending most of the time trying to see all the touristic places, then we just go in and we crash at a hostel. Yeah. It's cheap and we just need a place to sleep, so it works. Yeah. Another tip that I have for you is always download this app called Packpoint. So if you have it with you, it's very handy, because you just need to put in the destination where you're traveling. It will predict the weather. You can also say for how many days you're going to be there, and it'll tell you what to pack, what not to pack. So you also travel light.
So we're going to talk about where all we have traveled. Vinny, why don't you start?
Okay, yeah, so far we've been to 29 countries, and most of the countries we've done have been within Europe. Apart from that, we've also touched down USA, Canada, Australia, a little bit of Asia, Malaysia, Thailand, New Zealand. Yeah, so we've done quite a bit, but
and the list goes on.
A small percentage, even though it's like 29 countries, we think it's a really small bit, and we have like so much more to do. So I think it's high time we stop counting and we just go on.
Yeah, We started our trip with our honeymoon and it was an amazing experience. We had a road trip in south of New Zealand.
Yeah, so I think that's how it started. Like our first trip itself was like a 10-day south of New Zealand road trip, and it was an epic road trip. It was really good. And that's when that was really good because that we were newly married and we were just getting to know each other.
Another amazing experience within India, I would say, was the hiking at Kedarkanta. It's in the kind of near to the Himalayan region, and that was beautiful with the snow-capped mountain, and it was more of a winter trek. That was amazing.
Yeah, usually people, they when they say they want to see snow, especially Indians, we always want to go to Switzerland or to the Alps, but we have like so many beautiful places in India. I would highly recommend you visit that because it's, first of all, it's cheaper, and I felt Kedarkanta was more beautiful than Switzerland because we have done Switzerland, we have been to Germany during winter, but somehow the Himalayas, it remains our number one favorite, and it was very affordable. We highly recommend you look for places within India and then travel abroad.
And right now we're in Spain, so our main aim is to cover as much of Spain as possible.
Another travel goal, or what is there in my bucket list, is I've always wanted to visit Iceland. I see a lot of people doing it. I've been reading a lot of travel blogs, but I know it's expensive and it's not something I just want to do it in a hurry. We thought we'll just wait for the perfect time and then probably go about it. So Iceland is definitely on the itinerary, though it's going to cost a little bit of money. We're going to try and make sure we do it in our minimum budget. Another thing I've always wanted to do, and which I hope to do someday, is I want to take like a 6 month or a 1 month break and travel the whole of India by Indian Railways. So this is something which I saw in a Tamil movie again, Yenai Arindal, where Ajit takes his daughter for I think 2 years by train, and they visit different places, and he kind of adopts the homeschooling kind of thing. So basically trying to say that, you know, you learn a lot more when you travel than what you would when you just sit within a classroom. We are right now at Tibidabo Mountain, and it is one of our favorite spots in the whole of Barcelona. You can get amazing views from here.